Hallo? Ist noch Atem? Hi everybody. Thanks for coming guys. It's just a bit quiet one this week. We have our own new newspaper here if anybody wants to grab themselves a copy. It's about all the stuff we don't put in mainstream media. About the child abuse that's going on in Scotland right now. For people that aren't aware, there's a Scottish child abuse inquiry. And it's currently investigating every single institution in the whole of Scotland for abusing children. They also kidnapped and murdered children. There's children across Scotland in mass grave sites and unmarked grave sites. These children, people are walking over the grass every day and they're not aware that these children are buried there. So there's 400 children in an unmarked grave site in Lanark and St Mary's Cemetery. And that's just one of them in Scotland. For years and decades, Scotland's institutions have been systematically kidnapping, raping, murdering and torturing Scotland's children. Most people aren't aware of it because they don't speak about it. But there's currently a Scottish child abuse inquiry taking place right now. Right now it's the 6 boarding schools in Scotland that have been investigated. One of these boarding schools was the Queen Victoria School in Dunblane. And that's currently being investigated right now. For what anybody doesn't know, there's a 100-year secrecy rule in Dunblane that protects a high elite profile paedophile ring. All the children in the Dunblane massacre were shot with Thomas Hamilton. Thomas Hamilton was a paedophile and he was in the Queen Victoria School in Dunblane. The Queen Victoria School in Dunblane is a Ministry of Defence school and there's a 100-year secrecy rule that's protecting paedophiles by politicians. Some of these paedophiles are people like Tony Blair, Gordon Brown. They used the shooting ranges in the Queen Victoria School and for years they were abusing young boys. They were taking these boys on weekend trips away in the boats and stuff. And as I said, these children can't come forward and tell of their abuse because there's a 100-year secrecy rule that they put on it, protecting these paedophiles for 100 years. We're campaigning to get this 100-year secrecy rule lifted. We're also campaigning. For anybody who's unaware, there was a town hall paedophile ring just recently. Two members of that paedophile ring were allowed to commit suicide for all deal. Paedophiles should not be on bail and allowed to commit suicide. Paedophiles should be remanded straight away and kept off the streets. There's also 96 members of a grooming gang that are running about in Glasgow City Centre. They're grooming young girls and across all these flats. They're on loads of properties, they're using Airbnbs and they're grooming these young girls and prostituting them out across flats in Glasgow. Once they've tackled these girls all around Scotland in flats, they're dropping them off at places like the Four Corners, down in the Gorbals, and on the bridges and stuff. And these girls have been prostituted out. Now, these girls are terrified. These guys buy the mobile phones, new trainers, build their confidence, tell them to keep a secret. And before the girls know, they've been drugged and raped in flats across Glasgow. And then they wake up and there's pictures and photographs and video evidence of what's happened. And to them, they're blackmailed. A lot of these girls are still about just now believing that these guys are their boyfriends. And it's sickening. That's why we're out here raising awareness. The Scottish Government and the Child Protection and Police Scotland do absolutely nothing. Nicola Sturgeon has turned her constituency, Devon Hill, into the child trafficking and human trafficking capital of Scotland. She's actually led to streams and made it legal up there. The charities own all the buildings. She sells the whole of Devon Hill to one owner. So they own all the buildings. There's a homeless unit for children up there, but they're trafficking them. Nobody can get anywhere near it because it's privately owned. Just trying to think what else she's capable. She's also, for anybody who doesn't know, Nicola Sturgeon's just paid lobbyists to back low major consent for children to 10 years old in Scotland. So she's trying to low major consent to 10 years old. She is also sexualising your children and brought in a programme for 5-year-olds to learn sexual education in schools. This is the Scottish Government's way of getting a real child abuse. This is what they're doing to escape all the charges of historical child abuse against them. No major consent in sexualising their children. No major consent to 10 years old is not on. It's absolutely disgusting. People need to wake up. There's something really sinister going on in Scotland right now, and it isn't COVID. It's the child trafficking and exploitation of your children. Well, you don't even know your children have been stopped in school. With profiles being brought against your children while they're in school. For the removal of your children. There's police, for anybody else who also doesn't know, you need to start asking questions. Police Scotland, social services have got new laws. They can just come in and remove your children now. The Scottish Government have let them. The school teachers received a document last week for all children still in school. They will now be required to ask your children questions regarding, has your mother been vaccinated? Has your father been? If you say no to any of these questions, social services will be called and your children will be removed from school. They're targeting anybody that doesn't believe what they're spinning, basically. As I said, I've got a wee bit clear, it's all the stuff the mainstream media, so a wee small digger. The mainstream media don't cover. There's one of Scotland's worst paedophile rings in here with all their faces. There's also members of Police Scotland that are paedophiles in here. There's also politicians that are paedophiles in here. All three rotten about your streets in Scotland. Your children are not safe. The child exploitation and trafficking is right. That is the new virus and the new pandemic right now. Nobody's aware what's happening to your children. As well as the teachers are going to be told to remove your children from school if you haven't all been vaccinated and don't wear masks. Then your children will be removed from school by September. There's documents available online from the Scottish Government that show there's going to be mass fatalities in August. They're only in June. Come August, there's going to be mass fatalities. I can make these documents available online, they're already available on the Scottish Government website. So, there's going to be mass fatalities in August, and most of them are going to be by the people that have had two vaccinations. Now this is according to the Scottish Government, in 8 weeks time, not yet. But everybody that's had two vaccinations is going to die. Police Scotland have set up emergency fatality shelters, secured last week. They're deployable. So these emergency fatality shelters will be able to be deployed fast in the case of mass fatalities. These are called mass identification shelters. Police Scotland have just secured them. So guys, I would start asking questions. I seriously would start asking questions. There's government documents available showing there's going to be mass deaths in August. The teachers are starting to remove your children right now. And Police Scotland have mass identification fatality shelters. Everything's not what it seems. They are coming for our children. Whether we believe it right now or not, things are all going to know soon. Our governments are coming for our children. Our politicians, our institutions in Scotland don't want you here anymore. They want your children. We're not used to them. And that is what's happening, guys. So please go and research. Go on our websites, Expose Scotland, YouTube Expose Scotland, all the government documents are there for you to read yourselves and make your own mind up. We don't ask you to believe what we're saying, the information's all out there, it is the truth and it is factual. And if you go and research it, then you'll find out it's the truth. And I advise everybody to start watching their TVs and start protecting their children.
Yay!
If anybody else wants to speak, we will be here every Sunday raising awareness about the child exploitation and grooming and trafficking on our streets of Glasgow and Scotland. We'll be giving out awareness booklets about grooming gangs. We'll be giving out our own mini digger. We all, the Police Scotland paedophiles in it, and the politician paedophiles, and the dangerous paedophile rings that are all through rotten about on our streets. Half of them have new identities, but their faces are in here. So again guys, thanks for coming and we'll be here every Sunday for our children and get awareness out there and get people to start fighting for our kids. Cheers.
end up having that wee shot, Peter.
Oh, the wee shot.
And that's a good play, Peter.
Wow, I've got some news for you. It's not a vaccine. I wish people would stop calling it a vaccine. It's not a vaccine. It's a poison that they're putting into you. And I don't care really about the adults. You can all make a decision of whether you are going to take this poison into your system or not. And the ones that's taking the second one, all I can say to you is tick tock, tick tock, tick tock. Because you are sitting on a time bomb. That's all they've given you, is a time bomb. Some people will live a bit longer, depending on their immune system. But you just wait in the next 3 weeks. But these people that have taken the second vaccine are all going to drop in flies. Enjoy this bit of sun. Because I can guarantee you, in the next 2 to 6 weeks, she is going to lock you down again. 110%, she's telling you now she's going to do it. Because she cannot lift the emergency measures. So she's going to lock us down again. And if you allow your children to take this poison, you will be held accountable to God for doing this. Stop thinking that these teachers have your best interest and your children at heart. They are being programmed right now on how to vaccinate your children. And if you think by taking them out of school, that is going to solve the problem, I've got news for you. That is not going to happen. Because if they have to, they will come and knock your door down. We've seen it in Ireland, when a man was in church and they knocked his door in at 3 o'clock in the morning because he went to church and removed him and his children. You really need to wake it up here in Scotland. The whole world is walking the streets right now saying, you are not doing this to our children. And the only thing you are interested in is sitting round the Glasgow Green to watch football. And the only reason you're not locked down because the football makes money from Nicola Sturgeon. And I can promise you another thing. It's getting close. This is all going to come out in the open very, very soon. Very, very soon. Because it's coming, believe you me. And these doctors and these nurses that are injecting, when the trials, the Nuremberg trials start, these people will be held responsible. And they will be punished by law. So stop thinking that that's not going to happen. There's other things going on. And all I've ever asked anyone to do, I may be the biggest conspiracy theorist guy you've ever met, but all I've ever asked you to do is a bit of research. Take an hour of your time, go and look, and find out at least what's in the vaccine before they inject it into your child. You go into the pharmacy, you get a prescription for your child. The first thing you do is read the instructions to tell you what's in the ingredients. But yeah, you're quite happy to go along to the EC and walk straight in there and somebody's just gonna go bang, either to an adult or to a child. We need to take responsibility for the children. You need to do it. They will come into those schools. Don't think for 1 minute the teacher's gonna phone you up and say they're coming tomorrow. They're just going to hit the schools. When they finish the schools, they're going to lock you down and then they're going to knock on your door and say, your child's not been vaccinated. Well, I call it a poison. Under no circumstances is this a vaccine. Just go and do a bit of research. For God's sake, This is your children you're talking about here. You make a decision on those children. That's good. Walk away with your fingers up your asses. But I will stand by my people who stand here every week for the past 18 months trying to tell you people, enough is enough. When are you going to, when's the penny going to drop? Now the G7 is going on. They are the most satanic fuckers you have ever met in your life right now. Joe Biden, Boris Johnson, they're all devil worshippers, every one of them, and the royal family. They're all going to be brought to justice. So wake it up, Scotland. Get your fingers out your ass and do something. Thank you.
I'm going to put you on to Stephen for justice for Rhys, and he'll tell you about this is Rhys's grandson.
Who?
I'm Mr. Stephen Bonner. I'm Stephanie Bonner's dad. I'm Rhys Bonner's grandson, granddad. My grandboy was missing in 2019, July 19, July 24th. He went missing that night. A woman called Dee Dee and her pals, we live in Provin Hall, up Conway Road. On that day, police, missing persons on a Friday, he reported Rhys been missing on a Friday, 2 days after he went missing. That's all he's been doing. We need to wait 48 hours then tell the police he's missing. So we waited 48 hours, put the police on Friday. 26th of July 2019, the police took on missing persons investigations. They didn't investigate at all. They just said, go to your family, please. We gave them all the answers they needed. I've got a draw full of information since 2019, and I had it through the start for these people. I've interviewed all of them. Sorry, but I've interviewed people with suicides and that, and they take me as a fool, and they tell me what's happening. So they think I'm a daffy. I'm just a granddad, grieving. I'm just an ordinary guy here. Like yourselves, I'm sitting down just listening in here. I'm just a guy here. Rhys Bonner's my grandboy, 19-year-old son. 19-year-old son, you know. He was taken away in the fields, bushwalk fields with his DD. 50-year-old she was, no. He's 19-year-old, no. And other people are 50-odd and all. 49, 50-odd, 52. They're all there. I'm missing them all on Facebook. But both don't want to acknowledge I've got information here. They've given false information to my daughter every single time they get in touch with my daughter. At the start, a witness for Buckley Road said they seen Rhys Bonner walking down Buckley Road at 5 past midnight. When they called Buckley Road, my daughter, the GD, known drug dealer up there. 11 months later, the post gives my daughter's house, shut up the door and says, that was not Rhys Bonner walking down the road at 5 past midnight in 2019. It was somebody else. I want to find out who this person is. The police won't tell us. They just cease fire and down the border on our arse, no. They just want to go and do their own policy thing. Been told for the cap. They've been told, all these people here, and the police, the constables, they've got to do with their tell. It's their job to do with their tell. It's policy. But the law comes first, no. The common law comes first. And it should fight for the people. But they're not fighting for the people at all. I've got in here every Sunday, every Saturday, when the people here are fighting for their kids. My Rhys Bonner was 19-year-old, he was not a kid, he was not a child, an adult. He's a young adult, you know? A kid in my eyes. A kid in probably all, 90% of your eyes and all. This is a daily duty for the post on, post on. There's 1 in 10 of 3 has been harmed already. When a day, the 10 of 3 has, they could have investigated themselves. So we'll put it down, have a cup of tea, talk about it, leave it for 6 months, come back and tell you no. So why not help that I was going to chap doors, friend dude, did you see Rhys Bonner with this woman? Or did you see this woman? Or did you see his family? Or did you see his crowd? He didn't do that. He didn't do that at all. And you know what I saw, didn't you? So there's tools up there away. There's answers to be happier. I've got answers to my drawer still. They still don't want it. I don't care them. But this is going to turn affairs, the second one, PIRC, and it's up to them now. know, people are scowling, they're watching them. They're watching you, just Freeze Porter, Johnny Crowley, Alan Byrne Jr., just with Robert. It's a lot of people out there. They beat the injustices that are about. It's not just about the kids and about the adults, they beat the elderly and all, and the homes, care homes, and they're getting that end of life drug. I don't know the name yet. My friend Maureen's mum, needs to get a mum out of this room, because they're poisoning her. These people here have been told in policy to give them these tablets, or whatever it is, tag, whatever, I don't really know, but it's the end of life drug. This is cruel. What are they doing? It's cruel to the kids, and cruel to the adults, and cruel to the elderly. Is there any life in Scotland anymore? And you just sit back and watch, or you just give our son, tell our son to him. I'm looking at you sitting here. I know you're loving the day here. I know you're listening all. But some people that don't listen are ignorant. And that's no use. You're the public. You don't listen to me. Thank you for listening. And I only want to promise here. I'm taking this case to the very end. I'm going to do a civil case against the force and the people who are involved in this case. This is not going to finish ever. This is cruel, cruel to my family. My Stephanie Bone is up here in bits. Yeah, she does it on Facebook. Yeah, she says what she thinks. She feels. This is what she feels, this is what she thinks. So you go to Stephanie Bonner's Facebook page, or just for East, you see the pain and anger. The Post won't do their job. Now, I've got a lot of information here, I won't put it against the Post. I've stopped going against the Post the last 3 months now. So I've tried to do my best now, a bit of respect to them, and give us a bit of respect back, please. I was going to video the Post for the very start in 2019. I was going to take my information to myself on video, so I had it. I should have done it, but my daughter says, no, Dad, don't do that. The Post won't help us. They think it's annoying them or something. So I stopped it. And my daughter says, now, Dad, I wish you did do that. What are the Post doing to me, Dad? I don't know. I'm eating bits. My boy's away now, he's just born. He's not 19 year old, no. It doesn't matter when you wake up in the morning time. It's when at night time you close your eyes. Do you sleep? Do you sleep, man? Do your kids, whatever, any kids at all, about you, what happened to you, what happened to you, any of you? If somebody come here and talk about the answers and tell the truth, these people will be here, it's time for them. But they won't tell the truth because they're too frightened and scared. They don't want to be put in a week ever, like us. You know? I'm happy to hear from Andy and help the kids. And hope people stand looking and stop trying to bully this lassie. Stop doing what she's doing. She's doing it for Scotland. And please, these people are strong in England, Ireland, and Wales, Northern Ireland. Please, in all Europe, no, please. Listen to this, Mandy. She fights her water, fight for the kids all day. All these people here, you see here. Somebody here with Saturday and Sunday. They just need a press, just to get the water out. So you please listen. You may know to get in. You please try and study it about, hey, try and go on Facebook. It's a bit crazy. People tell lies on Facebook, people tell truth on Facebook. There's opinions on Facebook and all. So you're up here, you're button, please help. Reese Bonner, Johnny Crowley, Alan Byrne Jr. Just for Robert, just for everybody, just for the kids. It's everybody we've got to look forward to. I'm going to say for Reese, I'm going to say for everybody else in the future. The future. Have we got a future here? Oh, just policy. The carbon law seems to be gone now. That's what we're for it every Saturday and every Sunday we come here. We don't get carbon law, we've got nothing here. We're not going to fight here again, ever. This is going to go away, we need carbon law. So people need to stand together and listen to the Post what they're saying. Is it awful? Is it just policy they're doing? Yes, the Post are good sometimes. Yes, they find their kids when they're lost, yes. They find the people are dead, yes. But we call the Post scrolling video. Well, not me. People on Buffalo Drive did a video of Reese Bonner getting dragged. Massively. My nib in his body. Damaging his body, his bones, his whole flesh. So they need to investigate. Because they're already doing something to Reese Bonner. They abused Reese Bonner after his friend who dragged him 800 yards in Bishop Rock Fields, poor land. They're keeping a helicopter there. Right? They could have been a stretcher there, could have been a banger in the place. I've shown this in videos. So Johnny Stephen Bonner, I'm a father, a Stephanie Bonner, and granddad of Reese Bonner. I've got videos in my place. And my buddy, you can see it all at Bishop Lock. You can see how easy it is to walk through it all. How to get a motor through it all. How to get an ambulance through it all and put them up. Don't ever drag my grandboy out a bridge that was broke to pieces. His brakes didn't look at and all that. He wasn't even up to pieces. Sorry for Stephanie Bonner. I'm sorry for seeing this. It needs to be said down. The Post don't give a fuck down. I'm sorry. Ah, dude, it's my grandboy. And I care for your kids and all. That's what I'm doing here for. Not just for this Bonner. everybody's cancer. Please go on Facebook and try to support Seth Dakota and Donald McCluskey and Aaron Bryan Sr. They're all waiting for somebody to help me, please. And of course they're not helping us, though. They're not helping us. Sorry. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you very much.
What a brave guy. Now that's why we are here every week. People like Reece Bonner are 19 years old. Now a woman murdered him and she's still walking about the streets drugging young boys, taking advantage of them to this day. When you get Reece's granddad Stephen and Stephanie, should they be having to be out in the streets screaming for justice for their son and their grandson? Police Scotland should be doing something. This is a family that the police done nothing. They left that wee boy missing for 15 days. Then he put a search party for him. Then when they did, he was told he was with a known murderer, a known beast, a woman that was a lot older than him, who was a drug user and who had been known to drug people's drinks. And that's exactly what she did to Reece, and he was missing for 15 days. The police took no evidence, they took no statements, and then when they eventually did find Reece, they destroyed the evidence by dragging his body through the fields and bits of rope. His mother and grandfather had to see that on a Facebook video after their son and grandson had been missing for 15 days. It was absolutely disgusting, and now they're still trying to cover it up. They're still refusing to investigate, refusing to give them any answers because they made a mess of it so bad. But that's not what it should be about. It should be about having to face up to what they've done and give this family justice. So as well as Johnny's no good, Reece is no good justice, you have Johnny. Well, Johnny Conley was a young boy that was found in Spearsworth Canal. It was found that Johnny was assaulted before he went in the water, and that's why he died. Johnny's mother, Nora, comes here shouting for justice as well. They have never had anybody coming forward to give them any answers. They don't know who attacked Johnny, and they don't know how he ended up in the water. This is just two children, there's another couple of boys. The thing is, the reason why we're here is the Scottish justice system does not jail these people. Even when they are caught and found guilty, they're not put in prison. They're walking about with deferred sentences. I've got a wee booklet there, newspaper with all the Police Scotland in it. Every one of the Police Scotland paedophiles were suspended on full pay while they were being investigated. They weren't sacked, they resigned. They guys could be anywhere because they resigned, they could be driving black taxis right now. They didn't get jail sentences, they didn't get nothing. Some of them get placed in the sex offenders register, some of them didn't. Also, see if you're I don't know what way it is about, but see if you're a paedophile and you get the sack, you've been a politician.
Yeah,
politician. Wait, hold on. No, if you're a police and you get the sack for being a paedophile, you can become a politician.
That's
right. Aye. So if you're a member of Police Scotland and you've been charged with being a paedophile, you can still become a politician for Scotland. A politician can't become a police after being sacked, but they can become taxi drivers and stuff, and they're driving your kids about at the weekends, and they're paedophiles. There's loads of these people out in the streets. There's a worst, Scotland's worst paedophile ring is in that wee newspaper. They guys were meant to get life sentences. They guys were responsible. They were a paedophile network of 8 members. One of them worked in the LGBT youth and he was a school teacher. And the other guy worked in Celtic Boys Youth Club. These guys were the worst paedophile ring members in Scotland. They were raping babies. They raped children under 3 years old. They befriended families and got to babysit their kids. They raped their children and they distributed these videos worldwide. These guys, none of these guys get any more than 10 years in Scotland. They're out, every single one of them are now out with new lives. 10 years was the maximum sentence and he raped a 3-month-old baby and distributed it worldwide and they get 10 years in Scotland. This is why we're here shouting and bawling every week. We need proper sentences for paedophiles in this country. We're the only country in the world that you can have a convicted paedophile and you'll let him fly out to Thailand tomorrow. If you get convicted of paedophilia in Scotland, you can fly out tomorrow to Thailand and go and rape a child. This country is a disgusting joke when it comes to protecting our children to paedophiles. And the reason being is eventually we'll come out as there's people need the filings in the legal system, in the judges, in the courts, in the social services, the child protection, and they're right across the country. These paedophile rings are operating. These paedophile rings have connection with members of the royal family, who are also paedophiles. The list goes on and on, but ultimately your children are not safe, that's why we are here. And even if these monsters get caught, they go in one door and out another. It should do beyond. This is why we're trying to bring common law back, because if enough people stand under common law and you ask for these paedophiles to be tried under common law of the land, then it's up to us, not myself. If we wanted to hang them for there, we could, every single one of them, under common law.
Good idea.
Yep. But as the law stands now, the legal system, it's theirs, it's the paedophiles, and they're just going to keep protecting themselves. And removing all their own children to the people that they're removing them from. They're not removing them to paedophiles, they're removing them to loving families and giving them a foster care paedophiles. And it's just, it's never ending. So, guys, I hope we've raised a wee bit of awareness today, and thanks everybody for coming.
Yeah.
And again, guys, if you've just gone for justice for Reese and justice for Johnny, you'll see the two of the stories on Facebook. These families are fighting for justice. The whole point is to try and make Police Scotland eventually have to do something about it. These guys have had to go through absolute hell. No respect to the police, the families of poor hell. There's a beast running about the streets that murdered one of their children and left four other children. How do these people ever meant to sleep at night? Police Scotland and our establishments need to get their finger out and start protecting their children. And if they don't, we're going to make them. We're going to kick their children and make them protect our children. So thanks, guys. Cheers for coming, and I hope you all have a lovely day.
Thank you, Mrs.
I've just got a couple more things to say. There's a dark cloud hanging over Scotland as far as paedophilia are concerned. And believe it or not, it's all connected to the Freemasonry in this country. Every police is connected to the Freemasonry. And I honestly don't get why we are not walking these streets. A little bit I can understand, because you all think you're getting free money every time she locks you down. You think to yourself, nope, I don't need to go to work because the government's going to pay either 8% or 6% of my wages, and you think it's for free. There's not such a thing in the world as free. Not free at all. You will have to pay that money back somehow. We are all being made slaves. We have been slaves all our lives. And there's an opportunity here. There's a window open, but it's closing all the time. For us to say, we will not be slaves anymore. We've been lied to all our lives. They've been playing one game against the other. Catholics, Protestants, Muslims, Hindus. They've been playing us all. It's all been a lie. Your life has been a lie. And you just need to wake it up. They had you fighting over toilet rolls. Come on, have you not clicked that there's a pattern here? Then they asked you to wear a mask for 3 weeks. So they got you to wear the mask. And you're still wearing the masks. 15 months later, you're still wearing them. Do you think the masks will ever come off? No. Because there'll be people walking about here. If I told you right now that the government said you could take your masks off, I bet half of you are that brainwashed. You would still carry on wearing that face mask when you don't have to. All you have to say is I'm exempt. They've got no right to ask you why you're not wearing the mask. Has the penny not dropped yet? Well, it's going to drop very, very soon. And all you people are going to say, Nobody told us. The BBC never told us. ITV never told us. As long as you're prepared to be brainwashed with that shite that they call news, yous are all for it. Yous are all going down, especially one that's going to take this second vaccine. Why do you think they built these places, these morgues, for these people? Why do you think yesterday there was a young football player collapsed in the middle of a football match? Because he took his second dose of vaccine on the 31st of March. And you're still watching the football, you're still saying, this is great. Yous are being played. Played like you wouldn't believe in your lives. But I am more interested in the children. And I'll keep saying it. To every breath of my body's gone. You put that poison into your children. You're not any different from the doctors and the teachers that are doing it. Don't all you start crying, oh, my child's not well. He's had the reaction to it. When yous are the responsible, because what yous are doing, yous are sacrificing your child like they did thousands of years ago. In the name of God, but this is not in the name of God. This is evil at its best. And at the top of the tree is Nicholas Sutton. I'm afraid science played a horrible trick on that woman. Because that's a man dressed up as a woman. You make no mistake about that one. Oh, I forgot about you, thank you for that. Do you know when the children go to school? The teachers, you know, in 12 years, they can give the consent to take that vaccine. 10 years of age, they're going to persuade that child to take that vaccine. And your child's going to come home and say, Mum, I took a vaccine today and I don't feel very well. Well, I'll tell you what. It's not going to be a matter of saying, take a couple of aspirins and go. Because they're building these places right now for that purpose. And you do not even get a banner up to walk the streets and say, you are not damaging my child. Waking up, Scotland. Shame on you. There's a dark cloud hanging over this country. Maybe we're getting paid back for the things that we have done in the past to children. Maybe God's turned around and said, your children are going to get sacrificed. Because that's what's happening here. Starting from tomorrow, they are coming to the schools. I've just been told they've already started.
Yeah,
it's going to be. And I want these teachers held accountable. Their turn will come. There's no mercy for them. Because when these trials begin, because when they done it in 1949, all the nurses, all the teachers who done it in the camps when Hitler was about, were all hanged. So if there's any teachers out there, I'm not going to say, God have mercy on your soul, because you have no soul. If you are prepared to allow someone to come into your classroom, knowing of the fact that you put a poison in them, and I will never call it a vaccine, because it's not. It's a biological weapon. And all you have to do is go and look and find out, instead of watching whatever shit you watch in the telly, because I don't have a telly. I threw my TV out the window 6 months ago, and I nearly killed somebody.